Hey guys, welcome back to the Cantina. This is Stephanie. You know the rules. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos, no Ray nobodies, no sequel trilogy fans, no black pills allowed. My rules, my channel. Take the angry bullshit elsewhere. We don't do negative. Negative only pulls people down and things never get accomplished. That's why we don't do negative. Okay. We reach for excellence here. Anyway, want to talk a little bit about something that Polly at Latino Slant posted last night on his channel, and then Cameron picked it up on his Patreon page. Mike Sutton scooped everybody a year ago saying that they were talking about creating a trilogy for Heir to the Empire. Now, that being said, I'm going to tell you what this means. Heir to the Empire, in any form, cannot exist in the same timeline that the sequel trilogy does. It just doesn't. It won't. And it's going to be Disney Plus, he said, in this latest article, and it is going forward, he said. Mara Jade will be in it. Hopefully, we'll get some hint of the twins, okay? If that's the case, this is the best news that a Star Wars fan could have had, unless, you know, George himself showed up. What does it mean? It means that they're taking seriously the actual fans' concerns over what they've done with the franchise, and they're taking seriously the obvious lack of sales for merchandise, the fact that, you know, the Galaxy Cruiser is not, it's a bomb, all right? I have a theory that Chapek wanted it to bomb so they can fix it or get rid of it or change it, whatever. That's very Machiavellian, but sometimes you gotta burn the house down to fix what was broken, okay? Which is what I think he's doing. A lot of people, I wanna address this, a lot of people, are telling everybody they spent too much money on the sequel trilogy. They can't just dump it. They didn't make any money on the sequel. They lost money on the sequel trilogy. Why would they keep it? Okay. Why would they move forward with projects from that sequel trilogy they know aren't going to sell? Look at Resistance, that show on Disney. Didn't last, did it? Okay. It did not. It lasted 2 years. People mocked it. Went away. Okay, you gotta remember stuff like that. This is not about how you feel anymore. Okay, this is about money. Sure, they sunk probably $10 billion into the franchise and into the parks, and they've gotten about $2 billion, maybe less, net box office. Now, black pills will only bring up gross box office, as do the shills. They're basically the same size of the same size of a coin, or two different sides of the same coin. Okay, they're gonna tell you the same thing, but in different ways. Gross box office, sure. Net box office, no. They lost money. So why would they keep putting money into it? Okay? So my feeling is this is a way for them to push Disney Plus. It is a way for them to gain new subscribers. And it is a way for them to get the fans back. Okay, now, there are gonna be fanatics out there screaming that it isn't right and attacking Favreau and Filoni because it's like a dog chasing its tail, all right? They really are, and they'll never be happy. So they might as well be ignored. If you can take stuff from the EU and fix what's broken, do it. You don't have to have the entire, you can't do it anyway. Put everything verbatim per word, per book. But this is good news. I'm gonna leave a link in the description for you guys to read the article. And we'll just see what happens, but things are moving. I really wish Sutton would have actually done some searching on the Acolyte, because the moment that's announced that it's not going forward is the moment that we know Kennedy's truly on the way out the door. That's the one project that still sticks in my craw personally. It's got to go. Okay, anyway, just wanted to update you guys, and I will see you later, and have a good Saturday, and maybe I'll go live later. See you on the couch.